So many questions floating in from the interweb. All for me, apparently. So, I'm here to answer your questions in a vlog format.
Twitter time!
At Katie is Strange asked, what is my favourite song off Bruisers? And that is Aging Love. And that's all I need to say about that. At emo underscore band underscore lover, I believe that's correct, yes that's right, said what's your favourite song, and then Cheekin asked the second question of that and said any tips for people starting to learn the bass? Well, I'll say favourite song's always changing, but one I always go back to is Life on Mars by David Bowie, because I wish I'd written that song. It's a work of pure genius in its popness and its intelligence and how it's written, how the chords are structured, the melody, blah blah blah, all that sort of stuff. Any tips for anyone learning the bass? I don't know, because I've learnt first on guitar and then I'm still in a way kind of learning my part as a bassist, but in learning any instrument, particularly, you know, kind of a guitar or something, because it's generally, I guess, the music you listen to, sort of rock music, I just like playing, jamming along to new albums I've bought, favourite albums. Just, you know, playing for fun. The more you play for fun, the more you're gonna, you know, the more you're gonna improve. And then obviously, try and work in, if you really want to get good, work in little sort of technical practices, like practice your scales and all that sort of stuff. Try and learn, force yourself to learn new techniques and new styles. But yeah, the main thing is just, you know, when I was in high school, when I was really playing guitar, you know, all the time, and just gotten into music and stuff, I'd just come home and for hours just listen to music and play along with it. You know, I was rubbish, but it definitely helped. Just the sheer amount, the more you enjoy it, the more you're going to play, so play along to the stuff you love. At Breaking Rad with a 4 instead of an A, asked what age did I start learning instruments, and probably as a kid, I guess I learned like ocarina and recorder at school, like most people, quite young, but I can't really remember. I think I started learning guitar and clarinet, which were like my first two instruments, properly around age 9. And you know, that's a long time, but I should probably be a lot better than I actually am for that amount of years. So I'm gonna say 25, just show off. At Betsy May asked, R2-D2 or Chewbacca? Chewbacca. I surprised myself, I thought it was going to be R2-D2. At Gina underscore Starlet asked, what is my favourite all-time song by the Manic Street Preachers? And again, it's hard to choose, but so I'm going to choose two, and I'm going to cheat. I'm going to choose from my two favourite eras. So one would be from... No, I thought of another one. There we go. Yeah, what am I going to choose now? Okay, from Holy Bible, I am going to choose... This Is Yesterday, which surprised me, because usually I go for Archives of Pain, but yeah, no, This Is Yesterday. I love that song. I think it's one you don't usually think about with the Holy Bible, because it's a lot softer, so it stands out on that record, but I love that song. It's amazing. And from the closing track of Everything Must Go, All Surface, No Feeling, or no. And the closing track from Everything Must Go, No Surface, All Feeling, because it's just epic and amazing. If you haven't listened to it now and do yourself a bloody favour. At Frankensheet asks, would you rather have screaming llama heads for feet or snakes for arms? Serious question here, and that is a serious question indeed. Definitely I'm going to say snakes for arms, and my logic on that, because you might be thinking, you know, what you're thinking, they're going to bite you. But if they're, you know, if they're a part of me, surely I'd be able to control them in some way, you know, surely there would be, you know, an appendage in my body to be used appropriately, whereas the screaming llama heads, even though, being feet, they would be attached to me, I would be controlling them. The fact that you have to describe them as screaming implies that they're probably screaming all the time. That would get very irritating very fast, whereas the snakes could use as, you know, weapons against my enemies, or, you know, just, you know, it'd be good to... If I drop something under the sofa, if I drop 2p under the sofa and I want that back, you know, a little snakey arm could probably slide under there quite easily. So, yeah, snake arms. At TYNUV asked, do I write songs with Keir's voice in mind or just the song you want and adapt it later if needed? It's probably the latter, really. unfortunately, I'm not very good at writing songs in the range of my voice, let alone writing in the range for someone else's voice. So yeah, I just kind of write stuff and then I'll be kind of, you know, singing it softly, falsetto, where everything sounds a bit rubbish, and you go, oh no, it'll be fine when I sing it in full voice. And then realise, even when I come to record the demo or come to learn it with Kia, realise, oh, it's actually like several tones too high beyond our breaking point. But in fairness to Kia, he always meets the challenge and surpasses himself. So I think he does well putting up with my little quirks of songwriting. At R5, Tomps asked, if I wasn't in FEK, what would I be doing? And the answer is probably not much. I don't think I would have either had the sort of confidence or knowledge to push myself far in any field I wanted to. I mean, I'd love to say, you know, either in a band of some sort or writing music for film, or you know, I'd like to be writing something. You know, I love, you know, kind of comic books and sort of scripts, doing something creative, but probably I'd just be doing something menial and most of my time would be spent watching DVDs and Netflix Netflix binges and being a generally lazy human being. But I'd be very good, I'd probably be much better remembering quotes from my favourite TV shows, so I'd be good at that. I'd be slightly obese in the pub in Beccles, just quoting The Simpsons to people. That's probably what I'd be doing. Okay, we reached the end again, so I will just say ciao, and I'll see you on the flip-flop. Catch you later, dudes.